All right, guys, I'm sure you can't see me. I got an early start out here on Logan Martin. Gonna play around a little bit for this topwater bite. I'm gonna try hard to get bit on this Mega Bass Maggrass Freestyle. I got the 6-0 Colorado bladed flashy swimmer on the 6-inch Maggrass Freestyle in white. So I'm gonna try that a little bit while it's still a little bit dark. You won't be able to see very good if I do catch them, but we'll just see what we can do after that. I'm gonna probably try some deep cranking and some docks and just run around, see if I can find some ledges, do a lot of graphing, and we'll just see what happens. So just stay tuned. There he is. This is the first fish, but I have missed so many good fish this morning on this jackal cut rat, and I probably should have switched to something like a plopper or something that could they could track a little easier, but I'm just getting such explosive bites on this, I don't want to put it down. Not too bad, second fish. I missed way more fish than I've caught on this thing, but I'm just having fun with the jackal cup rat. If you haven't seen this bait, a little closer look, pretty much like a jitterbug with a longer body and a little prop on the back with a swinging hook. Stripe. Oh, I didn't even hook him in the mouth. Hooked him right through there. Ah. You can see how all these fish blowing up behind me. White bass. It's hard not to throw at them when they're busting like that. You never know, there might be some bass mixed in, but this is the Molex Trago. It's a little tail spinner. You see it, it's a 1/2 ounce. They hit that, and that's pretty much as soon as it hit the water, but I'm just kind of reeling it kind of quickly through the school. Oh, another one. here pretty soon. I need to hurry up and make myself leave before the sun comes out all the way. I'm gonna spend all day here catching white bass. Looky there, little spot. There are some little bass in here. Not much to them, but it's bass. It's actually a largemouth. And he's a skinny little largemouth. Spot on a 6 cents movement 80x. Got a little one. Oh, he comes off. He's all over the place. Little one on a Ned rig. Just come off this point, throwing in the shade with it. Throwing it brush out in front of docks. Now with a jig, little spot, nothing too crazy. Well, yeah, I had to run a hot wire straight to my depth finder because I had it originally ran through the accessory switch, and it, gosh, dang. It's not very big.
Oh yeah.
Spot on the jig. Big, little large mouth though. Under a dock. Little large mouth on the Ned rig. He wanted that thing, trying to swallow it. Beat up. Spot skipping some more docks. I graphed around for a few minutes, didn't really find nothing I liked, but man, the fish under docks seem to be pretty small. Finally, a solid fish, not a big one, but he's solid. Gonna jig on the outside of docks where there's mayflies hatching right here, and there's a bunch of brim around, so that's probably what he thought that was. Bad. He hit me in the face with something. That was my speed crawl. There he is, a little spot. Good. spot. This looks a little better. Got a tree over here with mayflies hatching in it. Oh my God. All that's in his mouth is little pieces of mayfly. I don't know how well y'all can see it, but it's all over me. Spot. I'm just scrolling down the bank, and every tree with a mayfly hatch, I'm casting under it with this jig. I'm not getting bit under every one, but usually I get more than one. Let's see what happens when I throw in there again. Not very big. Fighting for one though. Good Lord. Little spot. And this mayfly hatch. I'm hoping there's a lot more fish stacked up under this tree. Big. It's a large mouth. Little bitty one on the jig. Oh yeah, I don't know if it's a bass. Might be. Nope. Strike. Top of the head, so he felt like a monster. Right. Six XD, just throwing off a point about 18 foot of water. All right guys, that's it. Man, fish are scattered. There's plenty of them under docks. There's a few of them on ledges. I haven't found any ledges today that was holding more than one or two fish, but the mayfly hatch definitely had some fish on them. I was catching one to two fish under each tree I found with an active hatch, with, you know, mayflies flying around pretty good. But anyway, that's it. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe. Be sure to hit the notification bell so you'll get notified about my future videos. And until next time, I'm Jonathan Harris. Thanks for watching.